A while ago, I did a tutorial on how to create this glowing effect in Photopea. I decided to make an updated video that outlines the process in a clear and straightforward way. I hope you will find it helpful. We'll use the same concept as in the original video and we'll apply the effects to Antlers antlers to create a surreal fantasy image. You can use the same method to add cool lighting effects to any object in your pictures. To start, after opening your image, go to the Layers panel and make a copy of your main background layer. To be able to apply effect to the antlers, we first need to separate the deer from the background. I will use the quick mask mode for this purpose simply because I like to use the brush. If you want to use the quick mask mode as well, click on the quick mask icon in the toolbar. Then go to select and all, and assuming your foreground color is black, press Alt plus Delete to fill the canvas with black. As you can see, the whole image is overlaid with a red color, which means that now nothing is selected. Pick the brush. Switch to white as your foreground color by pressing X on your keyboard and start painting over the objects that you want to select. Now, since this is not the topic of this video, I'll skip ahead to the end of the step to save you time. Once you have your selection done, click again on the quick mask icon and your selection will be visible. Open the layers panel and make a mask out of it. Now that we've separated the deer from the background, we need to make a selection of the antlers on a separate layer. But first, bring back the selection we made earlier by control clicking the mask thumbnail. Pick any selection tool you want and make the selection around the antlers. If you're zoomed in, press the spacebar to navigate through the document without switching tools. Once you're done, press Ctrl plus J and you should have the antlers on a separate layer. Right-click on the antlers layer and pick Convert to Smart Object. Change the blending mode to linear dodge, then make a copy of the layer and go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur. Set the value to 5 pixels to add a soft glow. Make another copy of the layer and double click the Gaussian blur smart filter to edit the value. Choose a larger value of around 30 pixels. Add 3 more copies of this layer and adjust the Gaussian blur values to 60, 120, and 240 respectively. All these applicates add up to make a haze around the glowing antlers. Shift-click all the layers that make the effect and press Ctrl plus G shortcut to group them into a folder. To avoid confusion, double-click the folder and name it something like Glow Effect and name the layer below it something like Body. Next, we need to dim down the background to make the scene look like it was shot at night. To do so, click the background layer to activate it and add a color lookup adjustment layer. Here you can keep the default preset or you can import your own. The one I used is called Moonlight. This preset is not available by default, so we need to import it. Open the list of presets and click Load. And pick the preset file. You can find the download link to this preset in the description below. On top of it, add a black and white adjustment layer. And set its opacity to around 50%. Click on the glow effect folder to activate it and add a hue and saturation adjustment on top. In the properties, click the layer to the group so the effect is only applied to the antlers layer, then check the colorize option. Adjust the hue, saturation, and lightness sliders to find your favorite glow color depending on your image. To make the antlers stand out even more, we'll go ahead and darken the deer's body a bit more. Select the body layer and add a curves adjustment layer on top of it. Click the clipping mask icon and drag the diagonal line a bit downward to darken the deer's body. Next, make sure the curves mask is highlighted. Set your foreground color to black and pick the brush tool. Set the hardness to 0 and flow to about 40%. Draw over the areas where you think there should be some light emanating from the glowing object. In my case, it is the top of the deer's body and some parts of his face, etc. Next, click the hue and saturation layer, hold Alt key, and drag it on top of the curves layer. Make sure the mask is highlighted and press Ctrl I to invert the mask. Switch the foreground color to white and paint over the same areas as before. You may need to bring down the opacity of this effect a little bit. For me, 70% works great. I will link a Starry night sky image below. Now load it and open and place it into the document. Rotate and scale as needed. Now go to Image Adjustment Levels. Drag both sliders inward to increase the contrast. And change the blending mode to Screen to remove the black from it. Apply a mask to this figure and invert it with Ctrl plus I. Make sure your foreground is white, pick a soft brush, and paint over the antlers to add that glowing particle effect. I just noticed the background is not dark enough. This may not be the case for you, but if it is, click on the background layer and add an exposure adjustment layer. Drag the top slider to the left slightly until the background is dark enough. The final result is a colorful, illuminated glow effect that can be used to create all kinds of surreal artwork. If you have any comments or questions, leave them down below. Thank you for watching, and I will talk to you again soon.